guys, in today's video, I'm going to be reviewing the Versed. I always think of Versed whenever I see this brand, and Versed is the trade name for midazolam, a anesthetic. Anyways, I'm gonna be reviewing the Versed Guards Up Daily Mineral Sunscreen. I bought this at Target for $21.99 for 1.7 ounces. This is a mineral sunscreen that is tinted. It has a peachy tint to it. And the active ingredient in this is zinc oxide, which offers very good broad spectrum sun protection. It will protect you against UVB, the rays that burn. It will protect you against UVA, the rays that penetrate very deeply, destroy collagen, and also contribute to suppression of the immune system and lead to issues of hyperpigmentation, especially in deeper skin tones who are more prone to hyperpigmentation. Large particle zinc oxide also will protect against propigmenting wavelengths of visible light in the blue light range, which in people with deeper skin tones, especially those wavelengths of visible light are a major issue in hyperpigmentation. Now, this product also is tinted, so it has iron oxides in it. Now, iron oxides don't offer any protection against sun damage from ultraviolet radiation. They don't protect you against a burn or those rays that penetrate deeply and destroy collagen, but iron oxides can protect against those visible wavelengths of light that contribute to early onset and more persistent hyperpigmentation. This blue light or HEV light, the majority of it that you have to concern yourself with comes from the sun. Yes, to a certain extent, your devices, tablets, overhead lights emit this light, but it seems as though the exposure to that is kind of negligible from your devices. It's more so something that's coming from the sun. Importantly though, that visible light does come through window glass. So it's something you need to be aware of even when you're indoors, which is why I always emphasize protecting your skin daily, because when you're inside, you are still getting sun exposure through window glass. UVA will come through glass, as does visible light. So this product, the ingredients are good for protecting against UV and those propigmenting wavelengths of visible light. So these are really good ingredients for any skin type, but they're especially good if you have a deeper skin tone and you deal with hyperpigmentation. So you have acne that heals with a dark mark. You have a lot of discoloration that you're trying to fade. Maybe you had a rash this summer or some bug bites or something that have healed with discoloration. This is going to be something that you might want to consider to help clear that up. You want to protect that area really aggressively. The other advantage of this is that it is a zinc oxide sunscreen as opposed to a chemical sunscreen. Now, I love chemical sunscreens. I use them all the time. However, they can be irritating to people, especially if you have sensitive skin. They can cause irritation, especially if they have the ingredient oxybenzone. Those tend to be even more irritating. They can burn, they can sting around the eyes, and a lot of people have such bad experiences with chemical sunscreens that they swear off sunscreens altogether, and it really causes a major issue for people being willing to use sunscreen regularly. So zinc is a great choice. I mean, it's what's going to be in most baby sunscreens. It's so sensitive skin friendly, really good around the eyes. So if you have ever had any issues with sunscreens around your eyes, I would recommend trying this. It's good in that sense that it's not going to be irritating. While zinc oxide sunscreens are less irritating, they offer great protection. Unfortunately, they often leave a cast. But because this product is tinted, it's going to mask some of that. This product is free of fragrance, which is also good. Fragrance can be very irritating, especially in sunscreens, and many people are allergic to it. Even if you're not allergic to it, you can become allergic to it, and a lot of fragrance ingredients can cause vasodilation in the skin, which worsens redness and irritation. So this doesn't have added fragrance, and this product has an ester of ferulic acid. Ferulic acid is an antioxidant. It helps in your vitamin C serums to stabilize L-ascorbic acid, and it also can scavenge free radicals that contribute to not only hyperpigmentation, but photoaging. However, antioxidants added to sunscreens, because sunscreens form a film, you see, it seems as though antioxidants in sunscreens, they don't really get into the skin very well because of that. At least that's what the studies would suggest. So I don't know. I'm always very skeptical of antioxidants in sunscreens, but whatever. I mean, they're not really touting that on this, but it is in there. So I find this product is really difficult to apply. It has poor spread, meaning when you put it on your skin, you have to really work it to get it on. And what I noticed right away when I put this on is that the pigment kind of clumps out as the sunscreen is spreading across your skin. So you almost get like a comet effect where you have the head of the comet is most of the pigment and then the tail is just kind of the shearing out of the sunscreen. So it doesn't really, the pigment doesn't go on very evenly. And when I put this on, it takes me a long time to get a good application. The fact that that pigment kind of clumps out, I worry that a product like this is going to lead to a lot of skip areas. And I think part of the reason why it's so challenging to spread is just the ingredients overall in the vehicle. This product has a lot of wax alcohols, I noticed, which are great moisturizing ingredients, but I think maybe they should have balanced it out with maybe some more emollients or some silicones to just really help with slip and spread, because you really have to spend quite a bit of time rubbing to spread it out. I found it difficult to spread out on the skin, and I noticed there was a lot of clumping of the pigment. And as it's going on the skin, my first concern when I first started trying this was that it was going to end up pilling, balling, peeling off the skin. Fortunately, that was not my experience. It did stay put as I wore it throughout the day, and I had no issue reapplying it throughout the day. So I reapplied it a few times during the day, and I didn't have any issue with reapplying it. And once you do end up spreading it out on the surface of the skin, those clumps of pigment, they don't end up shearing out at all. They kind of stay clumpy and patchy. Ultimately, for me and my skin tone, this product leaves no cast, but it does leave those clumps of the pigment, which make me worried that I'm really not getting a good even layer of the product, no matter how I try, and that they're going to be just kind of patchy areas of uneven application. And I wonder, you know, while this leaves no cast for me, I question how this is going to look on a deeper skin tone. I was really enthusiastic when I saw this product for people with darker skin types, because I saw the swatch on the website, and I was thinking, wow, that's a deeper tone than a lot of tinted sunscreens. Maybe this is going to be a good one. But the way the pigment clumps out, I just wonder how that's going to look on deeper skin tones. I think this may work okay for olive skin tones. I'm just not sure, you know? I mean, for me, you can see those clumps on my skin, but there's obviously no cast. You know, there's no white cast. A lot of zinc sunscreens or titanium dioxide sunscreens, they end up making people with deeper skin tones almost kind of have a purple ashen look. I don't think you're going to get that with this. I think the pigments that they put in, the color, I think will prevent that. But given that it clumps out so much, I just wonder how this is ultimately going to end up looking on people's skin. The merits of this sunscreen are that it's got ingredients in it that will protect you from not only sun damage, but also from visible light, both of which contribute to hyperpigmentation in medium to deep skin tones. And it is zinc oxide, so it's not going to be irritating. It's very good for sensitive skin, and it's a great choice for around your eyes. The cons of this product are that it does that clumping, and I don't think people are gonna like that, alongside the fact that it just does not spread on the skin particularly well. A competitive product to this that I personally prefer and think it performs better on the skin, just in terms of the spread and the way that it ultimately ends up looking, it's gonna be the CeraVe tinted sunscreen. That product, the hydrating tinted sunscreen, that product goes on the skin like a dream. And doesn't pill, doesn't ball. You don't get any of this clumping or precipitation out of the pigment. It blends out evenly on the skin. The CeraVe product works pretty well for olive skin tones, but that's kind of it. It has more of an orangey hue to it, and it just doesn't go over well for all skin tones. But this, I wonder, you know, how you'll notice in the ad too, the model is phototype 4 or 5, if I recall correctly, and they show her with the blob of the sunscreen on her skin, but they don't actually show her rubbing it in. That would be very telling. I would like to see that from a company, that level of transparency, where you actually have a black model putting your sunscreen on in video form in real time so that we all can see. Because I've noticed this trend where companies will, you know, come out with a tinted sunscreen or something, and they'll show the model with like this, you know, okay. Have her rub it in now. Like, let's see really what it ends up looking on the skin. See how it clumps out? Even that just tiny little pea. Anyways, it's not particularly moisturizing either. It's more on the drying side, but it's not quite matte. It has a shiny look to it on the surface of the skin, I think because of the wax alcohols in this, which are, again, great moisturizing ingredients. I just don't think they balance them out well with emollients and humectants. And it kind of ends up giving your skin a shiny, waxy look. And the product, as a result, just doesn't spread particularly well. I prefer the CeraVe Hydrating Tinted Sunscreen and would recommend that over this. So yeah, that's the Versed or Versed sunscreen. I don't know how they want you to say their brand name. I think it's Versed, actually. I think that's how I decided it was when I reviewed the rest of their products. But anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If so, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and as always, don't forget, sunscreen and subscribe. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye.